What's up, Time Keepers? Me, Time Game here. We're back with another PC build video. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the first video of me showing you basically all the parts I'm putting in the video. And this is pretty much what it looks like when I'm ready to install everything there. And I got the first thing I'm going to do right now is put in the chip. If you guys haven't seen the video, the first video telling you all the parts I have, go check it out. Of course, we'd really appreciate that. Now, I don't know, it's not gonna be like a first step you have to do this video. I'm not good at terms and it's my first build. So I'll try to go through my thought process as I'm going. There'll be some time-lapse stuff hopefully going on and we'll see how it goes from there. So we got the nice little GPU right here. Nice little motherboard right here. There's a bit of orange on the GPU, but you won't see it too much with all the red going on here, so definitely will be going good. One thing I'm happy is all the power cables came, the EVGA power cables come with fucking Velcro straps, so those are gonna be reused for good use on the and everything going on here. So it's a big task. It's already 9 p.m. here and I'm working tomorrow, but I'm gonna get it done before I go to bed and hopefully power it up and at least try something out before I go. So let's get into it. All right, so we're gonna start off with the CPU. First off, we'll open the clasp here. Nice and slow. This is the hardest part of this build. The triangle, the smallest little triangle is right here. So we're gonna have to make sure on the chip that we're going the right way. Now, if you see me make a mistake, this is gonna be right in this bad boy. All right, so we got it good here. Nice little CPU. Ryzen, all right, so golden triangle, top right. Oh, it fits like a charm. And there you go. Hardest step is done. All right, I think right now we'll move on to, I guess we're gonna move on to the memory right now. All right, so first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna install the memory cards, the DDR4. So as you can see here, it tells us what order we should put them in. So it's gonna be pretty simple. So we're gonna go here. So one and two. Now these, awesome little thing, only have one way they can go in, and they go in like this. So let's start off. Sorry, we might not see everything going on here because I want to make sure I'm installing it properly. All right, sorry about that. There we go, sitting well. Just gonna that's one done,
and here goes number two.
Ooh, these are a beauty. Once they light up, they're gonna be pretty fantastic. Trident Z, RGB, extra FPS. all right. I think the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna prepare this part here. I'm gonna move, that's weird, the two fans, they send me one black one and one that's, I don't know why it's like that, but anyway. I'm gonna be putting my cooling over here in the front because I feel like that's gonna be the best spot. Because if I put it up here, I feel like the wires are going to be jammed up. So I'm going to put this fan over here. I might buy later time two more of these sort of fans to put up here. So now the only thing I need to understand to do is which these have to be intake and put them exhaust, which I'm a noob. So I'm pretty sure it's sticker in, the sticker is the face to where the air pulls in. So I don't know. So I'll set up my air cooler because I need to put the fans on and make sure I put all the brackets on the motherboard and we'll go from there. So one cool thing that I saw, one cool thing that I noticed is it comes the water cooling system, AIO comes with a fan hub, so this is going to help me out. Instead of having four cables going to the motherboard, I'll only have one instead. There's four fans all together, so we're going to make this work pretty good. So yeah.
Don't you feel that he could get help? Come on and follow me.
Alright, the next part of the video, we're going to be putting and taking these brackets off so we can install our water cooler, which is already installed in the box, in the case. So I'll start by removing that. There is a custom backplate that comes with this one, so I will be needing the backplate also. And yeah, we'll go from there. Alright, time to install the IO shield. I think it's time to put in the motherboard into the case itself. Everything seems pretty good. Just to make sure, the only thing I have left to install is that. I have the GPU, the memory boards. Power management, I'll do that at the end. Time to put in the motherboard. Alright, we're sitting pretty here. Alright, now the motherboard is fully installed. Awesome. Don't you be that Icaroo, get him, come on and follow through. Then you get your steady food. You make a joint jump like gators do. Alright, I'm back. It's a couple hours later. I have to charge my phone, so you guys missed just a couple of things here. I don't know if there's anything changed. I plugged a couple things here. Alright, so I plugged the two data cable, and the fan plug, which is right here. Which right now my cable management is not 100% done. I still have some wires to connect there, and I was about to put the GPU in pretty soon. But yeah, this is my this right here is my fan sort of hub. Hopefully it works. Some management done here. Now I'm starting to think that having my two CPUs like this might give me some problems here, because see, I got my two data cables. If I'm saying that right, data cables, and they're sort of bent out, and I'm afraid if I start trying to, I'm gonna unplug them and try to bend them back into shape to see if I can get them to sit flatter on the box there. Then I got my my 24 pin there. I got my CPU power right here that I may go through this here, where I'm gonna adjust the lower part a bit more. But it's getting there. So yeah, we'll just keep going from there. All right, I think right now we're gonna install the GPU. Not the GPU, I mean the water cooler. So this water cooler already has thermal paste on it, so I won't put any. I did buy some just in case I was having issues with it, but it should not be a problemo. So hopefully I did this. Shit. I might have to flip it around so the cables go downwards. God damn it. Because if not, I have to go something like this. And it's going to block my RGB. But I don't know if I'm on the bottom, if it's going to block me. Because I could go like this. And even there, I don't think it's going to work. I almost have to force it into place. And like this, it's not long enough. Might actually have to move it to the top there, and that's gonna screw me over. I'll switch the water cooler, I'll flip it upside down 180, see if that helps me, and we'll go from there. Fucking dumb. And I did my first mistake. There you go, put my finger on the goddamn thermal paste like a goddamn moron. Fuck. Alright guys, I'm back. So I decided to keep going. I had had some difficulty with the fan, I think, the last part I did. And I just decided to try to finish it off. It's almost 1 o'clock in the morning. I'm getting tired. I just want to power it up and see if it goes and at least get the OS installed and go from there. So yeah, here, let's take a look at it. Cable management is not too bad. It's not what I wanted, but it's going to work out. So just give me a second here. So that's what it looks like. I hate it a bit because of the two drives are facing one another, and I feel like that might have been causing me some problem, but the rest seems pretty good. This could have been a little bit tighter, but anyway, that seems fine. And then we'll just move on to the other side. All right, so this is what we got on the other side. Sorry if the film's a bit grainy here, but everything's plugged in. Everything seems perfectly good. I don't know if I should worry about these being there, but they seem fine. CPU cooler seems fine. Sorry, I didn't show you. CPU cooler seems fine. These are touching a bit here, but it should be fine. This is sticking out a bit more than I want, but it should be fine. Oop. Yeah, these wires are sticking out a bit much, but should be fine. The rest, the case has a good storage capacity, but like, still have a couple wires here. There wasn't any holes here, so I couldn't just pass it to where I need it to be, but I just got this little wire that keeps sticking out once in a while there. Okay, now it should be fine. All right, so I'll just maybe try to just adjust these a bit more. But it should work. Everything seems pretty fine and dandy. We'll have to see. I think my card's just folding down a bit. Nah, should be fine. Sorry. My card seems to be, seems a bit crooked, but we'll see what we can do with that. And we'll go from there. All right guys, we're back. Finally, everything's up and set. I got my monitor I was gonna use. It's not the best monitor in the world there, but it's gonna do for now because I ran low on budget. I did start up one to see if everything was good. I'll just show you guys. I'm plugged into the wall there, so let's just start the switch in the back. Where the hell are you? So turn on the power. Shit's gonna start turning on a bit. I think the RGB turns on a bit there. And anyway, we'll just start it up there. There you go. There we go. Everything seems to work. And we got it. Now I just have to put the Windows CDs in, and we should be good to go from there to boot it up into Windows 10. But I'm pretty happy with it. It looks pretty fantastic. I'm gonna change these RGBs to red only. This one glows red, which is freaking awesome. This fan I didn't even know was red, but that's pretty cool. I'm a bit disappointed I wouldn't see these fans. I hadn't mounted them here, but I just didn't have enough length to get my CPU all the way over there. CPU seems like it's going good there. It seems like it's sitting there properly. All the wires seem fine. The button, I turned it off with the button, so I know it works. And everything seems good here. Awesome lighting, awesome stuff. All right guys, so thank you so much guys for watching. I am exhausted. This, for my first PC build, I got some difficulties. You saw the wire management there in the back. It's fine, it should be fine for now. I'm happy with it, but this is a pretty sweet little system. I have to say I'm gonna be happy once I get it set up. I have so many shit to install in it, and thank God it's gonna be fast. Now I'm on my laptop loading the Microsoft tool. I should have done that earlier, but it's gonna take a while, so I don't know if I'm gonna stay up and try to get it at least to boot up to Windows to see. But for now everything seems, I'm just checking the fans, everything seems perfectly good to me. Oops. I'll get it. I'm just a bit exhausted. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. It looks pretty freaking good. And yeah, so thank you so much guys for watching. Hit the like button, subscribe to the channel. Show me your build in the description down below. We'd really appreciate that. I was gonna do an overclocking video and stuff like that. I don't know yet if I'll do that because I know it's a lot of pain. I don't know nothing about it. So I'll probably just screw around with it on my own time and we'll go from there. So thanks so much guys for watching. Hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, follow me everywhere, MeTimeGamer, Twitter, Twitch, Facebook, Instagram, and right here, youtube.com/MeTimeGamer, where I post a new video almost every day of the week, Monday to Friday, 3 p.m. Eastern time. So thank you so much guys for watching, and we'll see you next video. Keep on keeping on.